Hi, it's Josh Rachlis, my friend Anat, and she's visiting from Ottawa, and she's never been to Nuit Blanche here, and so she's going to be seeing it through the eyes of a virgin, sorry, I'm not even drinking yet.
We're going to go check out this coffee shop.
Oh yeah, coffee shop, first. Okay, so we went into this coffee shop here, and it turns out it actually is a coffee shop, and they serve food. Very realistic art piece.
I would love that.
Very cool. It's the first music we've come across. No, we did come across a couple of girls playing guitar, but it was the first cool music. Another food art piece. I don't even know why they're serving hot chocolate, but you can also look through the window and see people making pasta. I'm not sure what the point of any of this is, but at this point we'll take the free food. So, l'chaim. Is this going to be hot? I'm going to go burn myself? Okay, well, that's part of the art.
Here, it's good.
It's like melted chocolate. This is fantastic. I love art. Here we've come across the guy that picks up garbage for tips, and Anat is very impressed with that, and she's going to go give money. This isn't technically art, but it's kind of cool. It's a number of photographs of the same couple, and with little love sayings set on it, and the first thing Anat said when she saw it was, oh, that's so cute, and the first thing I said was, oh, I want to throw up. This makes me angry on many levels. First of all, that they love each other, whoever these people are. Also, this guy has, like, long, beautiful
hair. Why does love make you angry?
Because I don't have it.
Aww.
I hope this is a fake couple. Because, I mean, who is this happy?
It's probably just the picture that comes with the photo frame.
Yes. I've always wanted to be the guy that comes with the photo frame. They always look very happy.
Maybe this video will get you there.
I have a feeling it will. Can you explain what these pictures are? Because we were debating.
What were your thoughts?
Well, my thought was, ooh, gross, I want to throw up, look at this happy couple. But I'm thinking maybe this isn't a real couple. It's kind of...
Actually, it is.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's gross. This might not even be art. This might just be people drawing with chalk on the street. We don't know. But there's a little boy there. He might be the artist. Because there's no age limit on art. Now, his name is Riley, and he loves himself. And he drew it in a...
All you need is love.
I was going to say that's a cross, but it's probably some kind of video game button.
He's everywhere.
This kid, who's that artist that's he goes around the world and he's anonymous?
You know? Riley.
Riley, exactly. This is the famous Riley.
What did you draw?
Can you tell us about your art?
I did a cross and then my name. I did my name over here.
You did your name over here? Is that your cross too?
Yeah.
We recognize your work. And that's a girl in a miniskirt. Here we see there's some people painting on a wall. And then behind it, there is a party truck, we're calling it. We're going to see if we're allowed to join the party. I want a gold coin. This is art, man. Well, you can come by my condo gym anytime. You want to work out?
Sounds great.
Did you like how I awkwardly hit on her at the end?
Yeah.
That was
a good workout out of it.
That was my piece of art. There are some lights in the sky. It seems to be some kind of... Well, I can't tell exactly. No, go ahead. I'm just filming this for YouTube. It's not really a big deal. We just got our photo taken in front of a moon and stars by this fine gentleman.
Philip Sparks is a Canadian designer. This season's campaign is Man in the Moon, so now you're part of the Man in the Moon.
Check out the Man in the Moon on the wall. Oh man, have we sold out to commercialism here?
You sold out to Toronto talent.
Excellent.
All right.
Whatever. I'm fine with selling out, I'm just asking.
We have just spotted a guy with a beaver on his head.
Is that a beaver on your head?
It's an ox, man.
An ox. Did that go as well as you had hoped?
No, not really.
His friend was helpful, saying, yes, he's from an interstellar. Now, guys, break character for a second. We're freaking interviewing her. You know, you're not Borat. You can sort of just tell us what you're doing. That would have been more interesting. And we look forward to seeing you all at next year's Nuit Blanche. And hopefully somebody comes up with an iPhone to interview us this time.